In the spring of 1976, the village of Oak Park, Illinois, a town of stately trees and big homes, where Ernest Hemingway and Frank Lloyd Wright once lived, was declared to be an all-America city. Specifically, Oak Park was cited because of its citizen-initiated and voluntary efforts to maintain an open and integrated community, to revitalize its major business district, and to preserve its unique architectural heritage. Of all the cities honored, only Oak Park's award was based exclusively on voluntary citizen actions.
The Oak Park Farmers Market is just another example of what happens in Oak Park when somebody has an idea and pursues it, and the enthusiasm of the people is always there to support it.
The people in Oak Park are willing to try new things. They're willing to participate in something like a farmer's market.
The button means to me a successful group of people coming together to share their own interests and their diversifications in an enjoyable way.
But I think there's a reality about Oak Park that isn't very clearly expressed very often. And that has to do with Oak Park's tendency to really try to isolate itself from a kind of reality. Well, I think Oak Park is building a wall about it around itself physically. I have experienced in the city a world that's much more real and much more descriptive of the way it really is, and it didn't die. I guess my feeling is that I don't believe that the right world is a world that is controlled. And I was really uncomfortable with Oak Park All-American. It said this is a closed, white, middle-class, suburban community with beautiful, spacious lawns, law and order, where things are pretty well prescribed as to how they're supposed to be, and it really doesn't allow for the kind of vitality and interaction and energy that I would like to see in this community. And acceptance of difference, which I think is really absent. So I'm not very happy with Oak Park All-American.
Oak Park All-American City means to me that it really exemplifies a spirit of people living together of all different kinds, races, professions, white collar, blue collar, everybody living together peacefully.
Mom,
that's what it means to me.
Can I buy a tomato?
Okay.
Well, I don't really know. It isn't as all-American now as it used to be. Let's put it that way.
Happy power! Happy power! Happy power!
I'd like to live in Oak Park. I think there's a lot to offer. I'd like my kids to grow up here. I do. Being named All-American City is the best thing that can happen in Oak Park.
You want to spend the rest of your life in Oak Park?
I hope so. I don't know. If I find someone somewhere else, then I'll always come back to Oak Park.
Okay, we're going to talk today about Oak Park, the village of 62,000 people located on Chicago's west side. Oak Park is bounded on the north by North Avenue, on the west by Harlem, on the south by Roosevelt Road, and on the east by Austin Boulevard. We might also recognize two very important transportation corridors that cut Oak Park, the Lake Street L and Congress L. Now, I'd like to speak about a prediction I made about the population of Oak Park. Back in 1968, I was commissioned by the school board of Oak Park to make a projection of school enrollment. Enrollments had gone up by about 33%. So I made a projection, not just of school enrollment, but of black population in Oak Park. I made a prediction in 1968 that Oak Park would be 5% black by 1972, 10% black by 1975, and 25% black by 1980. The reason I did that was based on a prediction of block by block segregation based largely on this map. This shows the situation about 1968-1970, and I predict the coalescence of these two major ghettos, Chicago's West Side culminating in Austin and Maywood, to the corridor between the Congress L and the Lake Street L. As it turned out, my predictions did not come true, largely because the village took the prediction seriously and acted on that prediction in the program of managed integration.
My experience in Chicago is that when the whites move out, that also the police leave, the garbage service leaves, and the school started getting full of subs, teachers. And that's one of the base reasons I moved, because I had to find a good school for my kids. I read in a magazine, and a guy said that he would never stay in a community that didn't have good school for his kids, and this was really impressed me. But basically, if the block started going, because I find out when I first moved in, first thing the people in my block won't make me chairman of the block club. And while I'm being chairman of the block club, they is calling the Mayflower, getting their stuff together and move. So if it really get down to the nitty gritty, when they move, I'm leaving too. I'm not gonna get stuck, understand me. Wherever they go, I'm going too.
Historically, if we let things happen as we view it, if communities just lets things happen, you will not have stable integration. Our view in the metropolitan area of Chicago is that has not been accomplished. It's been by a block by block process of racial change, inundation, whatever people want to call that sort of thing. We don't see too many successful examples of stably integrated communities. This community, I think, has achieved that goal and is achieving that goal by managing the process, by trying to encourage people to live throughout the village of Oak Park, not to concentrate on one end or another end. Without that kind of affirmative action, I don't think that you'll achieve any kind of a goal for a stable integration. Stable integration, to me, is a community that has a viable white and a viable black housing market. And that will not happen by chance. It's never happened by chance.
The origin of the housing center was a meeting in my living room where about 15 or 20 people who lived in the village got together to discuss what could be done to accomplish stable integration in the village. And the conclusion was we needed something, an agency, that would deal on a daily basis with housing and try in some way to reverse the patterns that had taken place in other neighborhoods. Well, the housing center, quite simply, is a housing referral agency in the village. We are free service. We assist people who come into our office to find housing in the village. And at the same time, we are helping, we hope, to gradually implement the objectives that we have of assisting white families to locate at the east end of the village or in integrated buildings, and at the same time to be sure that our black clients are not subject to racial steering, which would steer them to one apartment building or one block or one neighborhood. It's a very voluntary thing. It's really up to the individual as to where they're going to move. We have no way to force people to do what we might like them to do. We can only encourage them and try to help them to understand what this village is trying to do. For the white who doesn't want to live in an integrated neighborhood, probably Oak Park is not the place for them. For the black who wants to live in an all-black building, again, Oak Park is probably not the place for them. There are a lot of places that you can live in, you know, where you'll get an all-black building, or a lot of places in the Chicago area still where you can live in an all-white building, not Oak Park. And what we're really trying to do is to attract the people to the village who believe in what we believe in.
When the reports start coming out that we're supposed to be 10% black or 20% black by such and such date, it's sort of normal that some people sort of panic. It hasn't happened. most of the people are coming into this community now are coming into Oak Park because of its situation. The housing values are soaring, and there's not that many houses that are going up for sale. There's a great demand for housing in Oak Park.
I think it really is imperative that any community faced with the challenge that Oak Park is facing or has faced has to be sure that the existing housing really meet the kind of standards certainly laid out by the housing code in a community like this, but also be a very appealing, attractive kind of place to be for people. I think probably what's kept Oak Park as alive and healthy as it is today is that we've had a very unique combination of groups working to maintain the quality of housing, in fact, to improve the quality of housing.
The Village of Oak Park has a neighborhood walk inspection program, which has been in existence for the last 3 years. What we do is go out and inspect each and every home on a specific block, looking for possible deteriorating conditions. What we do is then send out letters asking for their cooperation on a voluntary basis to eliminate these conditions. In some respects, the neighborhood walk takes the heat off of the neighbors. If there's a condition, let's say a bad garage, and maybe the neighbor on one side says, man, it looks awful bad, but he doesn't want to beef on his neighbor necessarily, the neighborhood walk inspectors going through the neighborhood solves their problem for them. What it helps to deter is the decay of a given block or a given area of a village.
I think it's very important to recognize when we're talking about Oak Park that this is not just a community of single family homes and large lots, but it is a community in which over half of the housing units are apartment units. In fact, most of these apartment units are older buildings that need attention. They need constant maintenance. We have not had one apartment building abandoned in this village, and I don't think we will have. The housing code enforcement is, of course, very important, but the quality of tenants, I think, is really the most important thing, and the quality of building owner. So a couple of years ago, we got building owners and managers together who were involved on Austin Boulevard. They met, they continued to meet, they began to understand some of the issues facing the village, and they began to have some input into policy of the village. Now that group is the Oak Park building owners and managers. It's not just Austin Boulevard anymore. It covers the whole village.
I want this 2-6 parking wall abolished so that when I pull up in front of my apartment, my home, I can get out of my car and go right in the house. I don't have to walk 5 blocks or a mile or pay the city or some homeowner $15 or $20 for a parking spot.
Well, it's a problem in Oak Park. But if we are able to do something or someone is, it might be years. So we're trying to find alleviations to the problem right now.
They are autonomous now. They're very active. I don't always agree with them. They don't always agree with me. But they're now really an active voice in the community.
Well, I first purchased a home. And then after I sold my home, I bought a building. And a few months ago, I purchased a second building. And I hope to purchase another building, because the property values are all going up. And everyone wants to live here.
Sure, there's a risk in Oak Park. There's a risk wherever you go. But I think that risk is certainly minimized by the type of cooperation you have from the village officials here in Oak Park, from the kind of community organizations you have. That risk is minimized. It still is there. There's no doubt about it. I'm out there on Austin Boulevard. I'm as exposed as any owner in Oak Park would be. But yet I have confidence in what's happening in this town and what's behind me.
We knew that we had to preserve the free market system in the apartment rental market, since half the units in Oak Park are apartment units. So we passed a series of ordinances designed to enable a landlord to make sure, A, that his apartment building could be interracial without threat of negative pressure, and B, that he could conform with ordinances that would ensure that he had economically qualified tenants. And so we passed ordinances that insisted on security deposits and leases and certain numbers of people, depending on the size of the apartment. And we went out, by golly, and we enforced it.
Basically, they just don't want poor people in Oak Park. I mean, they want middle-class people. They want everybody kind of look alike. I mean, this is a basic thing. I mean, just like somebody moving to Oak Brook, they want certain type of peoples. And so I wouldn't say it's racial here. But they definitely, you can see that they tear down buildings that low-income peoples move in, and they tell them they can relocate, but how can you relocate from a $150 apartment to a $300 apartment? So basically, they just don't want poor people in Oak Park. The color have nothing to do with it.
Is there anything wrong with that?
Well, I don't see anything wrong with it because, let's face it, this is a class society.
I've never felt that race was the issue. I think class is the issue in any interracial community, and it's just as much an issue for blacks as it is for whites, and there's no reason to feel guilty about it.
I'm Lee Ellis, presently Senior Vice President for Business and Finance at Northwestern University. But for 5 years, from 1971 to 1976, I had the privilege of being the village manager in Oak Park. We had 60,000 others who thought they were, but officially I had that title. A number of suburban communities are characterized by seeking to maintain the status quo and don't change anything. The contrary has been and is true in Oak Park. The other thing about that is that we're not satisfied to try one experiment. We felt that we have to experiment on a wide number of subjects all at the same time. We're much happier here to say, look, it's worth the gamble. Nobody else has tried it. That's no reason why we shouldn't. Let's do it.
There needs to be a rallying point in a community. In urban society, we tend to become so dispersed that there isn't a focus anymore. And I really do see the mall as performing one of those functions in Oak Park. There's a tremendous reason to shop Oak Park because the money that you spend to buy a product and you spend sales tax on ends up going into the budget of your own community and therefore paying for the services, the top quality fire and police and all the rest of that. And I have a feeling that Oak Park maybe realizes that more than the average community.
I ride by, you know, all the houses around here, and it's sort of reminds me of, you know, when you go into the library and you see first the Wright, you know, books, say, and then I saw some maybe of the Roberts books and the Talmage and Watsons, and they're certainly different, but they all have their own beauty to them. That they were the first architects, the American architects, to free themselves from historical styles and to go into their own American form of architecture. And they all have a different beauty. And that's what makes the architecture around Oak Park so great, is that the diversity is so much. One of my friends who I found through my interest in architecture was Dawn Goshorn. She was really the one who saved the Holman Studio from the piece-by-piece demolition that it would have gone through if it hadn't been purchased by the people in Oak Park. And it was her enthusiasm which was necessary to pull this thing through. Otherwise, the building would have been lost.
What does Oak Park, the All-America City, mean to me? We're it. We are citizen participation for community betterment from one end to the other. And I guess the exciting part of it is that I know this is true because there were at least 50 other projects that could have been named in this community beside ours that exemplify exactly the American spirit, that we can do it. We're a team, we can pull together, we can accomplish something together. An awful lot of people really caring about their own community. And that's America, the grassroots.
And the secret is that that the people here, I think basically the people in Oak Park make things work. Without the people, nothing happens. Even with your top officials, the people here make Oak Park work. I put in a whole lot of hours at different meetings, my wife do. A whole lot of my friends. We had meetings at the school board about once a month. We're meeting on housing, building, zoning, Alice. So you put in a whole lot of hours out here if you're going to make the village work.
When I was running for the school board, I've met so many families that have moved into Oak Park because of the changing situation. The people are dealing with racial balance. and it's young people that are coming in. When they're investigating, they find out how good it is, and they can't wait to come here. So, I don't know. I just am enthused about the town, and the more I get involved, the more I hear, the more I like it, and the more I intend to stay.
We were advised by investors, very good friends of mine, not to go to Oak Park because they said, you're dead. It's, you know, that was 4 years ago. You're done, and it won't make it. It just won't. And I haven't yet, but I want to go back to him and explain to him what has happened.
I used to have real estate people say, oh, you live in Oak Park. Oh, that's too bad. I say, what do you mean too bad?
Because we sold a house, and our house has been resold since we sold it, like for $25,000 more, like 2 years after we sold it to that owner. Now that's moving.
I think really the exciting part, the interesting part of being in this village, that that there is a constant challenge to create solutions to problems, and really kind of a we're a microcosm, we're a laboratory for testing new ideas, I think. It's funny, you go to a party in the community, and I don't know what people discuss at parties in any other community, but you go to a party in Oak Park and you end up in the kitchen discussing a lot of things having to do with housing and the village in general, racial integration and the relationship with other communities close by. And I guess to us it's probably something we never really tire of.
I'm feeling very clear that a value for me is living in an integrated community rather than a racially divided community. That's a value for my kids. And that it's hard when schools are perceived as having too large a minority population. Then people tend to move out of the housing area in which that school is, and it tends to become a segregated school. And I don't feel it's in my interest. I don't want to live in a segregated society. So I support the action of the board because schools have an impact on housing patterns.
What's relevant is who is going to move into the Hawthorne community.
That's right.
As long as there are multiracial people coming into the community, in the Hawthorne community, I know I say everything is okay.
That won't stay that way forever.
Well, it wasn't staying that way, no.
If you live in Dayton, Ohio.
Now, teachers were saying there's an influx. And baby, when I hear the word influx, that means black.
That's right. And
right.
Say there's an influx if families move in.
Right.
I'm going to deal with that.
I'm going to deal with that.
I mean, come on.
But if it was real all the way through, that people were not dealing with the fact that
the problem is.
My concern.
The problem is our taxes were not high enough. If we had our taxes high enough, then we'd only have high quality people moving in. Right. Taxes high to keep the riprap out. That's the slogan that you got.
Oak Park has succeeded so far in doing some of the things it wants to do. I don't think when you're talking about integration, about stable integration, that you can say on a certain date, we have now done it. This community is now integrated. We'll pack up. The housing center can close. We can all go home and do our needlepoint.
If you keep asking yourself the right questions, and never assume that you've reached the answer, that you're making it by definition. If you claim to yourself that you've made it, you'll get careless and smug. And then I think you'll stop making it.
5-10 years from now, I think it's still going to be a great community. As long as the people are willing to spend time, effort, to make it a good community. And if once that stops, well then the community will go down. But I don't think it'll ever happen because there's too many people that are too proud of what we've got now, and we're willing to work to keep it that way and improve it whenever we can.